Hi everyone, my name is Renu Kanti. I'm in my final year of computer engineering and today I'm going to demonstrate my DMW project, that is audiobook in Python. So we all know what an audiobook is, right? Basically it converts text to speech. So this is what I'm going to explain today. The input for this program will be a PDF file and the output will be speech. I will start by showing you the execution of the program.
Welcome to your audiobook.
So this is what the GUI looks like. Here we have an image, labels, entry field and three buttons. I will start by entering the page number. The zero indicates that I want to read from the first page, but you can enter any page number that you want to read from. And then after clicking on choose file, the file dialog gets opened. From here you can choose any PDF that you want. I have a sample PDF here and then I just need to click on start.
Beauty and the Beast. There was once a very rich merchant.
I'll show you the PDF here.
Children, three sons and three daughters, being a man of sense.
So you can see that this PDF is converted into speech.
But gave them all kinds of masters.
Then you can just close it. So now I'll explain the code. I'll start with all the libraries that I have used. Firstly, the most important library in this program will be PyTTSX3, which is the text-to-speech conversion library in Python, and it also works offline. And then the next is PyPDF2. So this is basically a pure Python library built as a PDF toolkit, and it is capable of many functionalities like extracting the document information, merging and splitting the documents, etc. And then I've imported tkinter. The entire GUI is based on tkinter in Python. And after that, the PIL, which you can see stands for pillow. PIL is basically pillow and it stands for Python image library. So if you want to insert any images in the GUI, you can use this library. And lastly, I have used threading. I'll explain later why threading was required in this program. So threading is basically used for creating and managing threads in Python, and it allows you to have different parts of your program run concurrently, and like it helps you simplify your design as well. Next I will explain the GUI part first. So the GUI starts from here. The GUI in Python is pretty much self-explanatory and the syntax is very readable, as you can see. So firstly, I have set the geometry of the window, that is the dimension of the window that you want, and then I have given the title, and configure is used to give the background color to the window. And then the image that I have inserted, I'll just keep the GUI besides.
Welcome
so you
to
can
your audiobook.
See it. Yeah, so this image that I have inserted, for this there is an image function available, and this image is basically used to put the image into the GUI, and photo image is used wherever the tkinter expects an image object in the RGBA format. So firstly, using the open function, we have opened the image called ab1.jpg, and then image resize is used to set the dimensions of the image. And this image anti-alias that you see here, so basically anti-alias is a technique for minimizing the distortion of the artifacts, and it is used when representing a high resolution image at a low resolution image. So that's why I've used anti-alias here. And then this resized image we have passed to the image1 variable, and this image1 I have used as a label. So basically what I've done is, the image that I have used as a label in my GUI, and then I have packed it. So it is important to remember that each and every element that you use in the Python GUI, you need to pack it at the end. And while packing, you can add attributes to it. Like here, I have added padding in the Y direction. And after the image, I have a label here. So I have two labels here, and here is the code for the labels. So the syntax is very easy. You just have to give a variable and then write label, and then you can give any attributes that you want to the label. Like here I have added the text, background color, font. So the attributes of various entities that are used will be same, like the font, background, text. You can use the same attributes to different things like buttons, labels, entry fields, etc. So after the labels, here is the entry field. So the entry field is basically used to get the page number from the user, and it is stored in the page number box variable. And after the entry field, there are three buttons. So in the button syntax, the important part is the command. So command basically states the function which you want to execute when the button is clicked. For example, there is a button called open PDF, which helps you choose a file using the file dialog that gets opened. So for this, I have given the command click. So I'll show you what the click function does. So you need to make different functions based on the commands of every button that you use. So in the click function, all we have done is I have taken a variable called path and initialized it, and then I have used file dialog.askopen filename. So what a file dialog is? A file dialog is a module which basically provides classes and functions for creating the file directory and selecting the windows. And ask open file name is the is used to display the open file dialog that allows us to select one file. So the file dialog that gets opened, it gets opened by this path, and the path of this process is stored in the path variable. So the PDF that is loaded into the program is stored in this path variable. So in click function, all it does is it opens the ask open file name file dialog, and the path is stored in the path variable. And the next button is called save. So this is the main button where we need to start the speech that is converted from the PDF. So here first I'll explain threading, which comes into play. So a thread is basically a separate flow of execution, and it helps two things happening at once. So here what are the two things happening at the same time is, first of all, the program is running, that is the main GUI part is running, and the second thread that is running is the speech, which runs in the background. So the problem that was arising was when I used to close the GUI part. So I wanted that when I close the GUI part, the speech should also stop automatically. And I haven't used any code to stop the speech. I wanted that when the user closes the window, the speech should automatically stop. But that was given an error because the speech was running in the background, and like both the threads were conflicting. That's why I have used threading here. So basically this helps to achieve the separate flow of execution when two things are running at the same time. And this is the syntax wherein you need to pass the target, and you have to set daemon is equal to true. So daemon is a process that runs in the background. In this program, the speech that is converted from the text is the daemon thread, which runs in the background. And why I have set it as true, because the daemon thread will shut down immediately when the program exits. Yeah, and if you set it as false, then the program will wait for the other threads to complete. That's why I have set the daemon as true. And then I'll explain the function for this button. So first of all, we also have to take into consideration the page number that the user has inserted. So the page number is inserted in the entry field, but to use it in the program, we need to store it in a variable, right? So for that, we have a get function here, which gets the input from the user and it gets stored in the page n variable. So before starting the execution, I have checked here if the path and page n is not null. So firstly, it will check that we have a page number and the path wherein the file we have selected is not empty. If it is not empty, then here I have initialized the speaker. The speaker is basically a variable used to initialize the text-to-speech conversion library. And now is the main part of the program. Like, the process of converting from text-to-speech is basically a five-step process. Firstly, we will open the PDF called PDF using the open function. And to this open function, as you can see, I have passed the path variable. This path has the file dialog path that we have chosen, and then RB. So this RB basically defines what function we need to perform after opening the file. So RB stands for read binary, which states that we want to read the PDF that we have opened, whose path is stored in the path variable. So the whole process gets stored in the book variable, and then the second step is to read the PDF. Here we used PDF file reader function to read the PDF. It is provided by the PyPDF2 module, and the object that we create here is read file. So we pass this book variable to this PyPDF reader, and it gets converted. The object is formed, which is the read file. And then the third step is to choose the page that you want to read from. So you don't want to read the entire PDF every time. So the user will be entering any given page, and only the contents of that page should be extracted. So for this, we will firstly pass the page n variable that we have acquired from the user, and get page is the function used to locate the page into the entire PDF. And then we have used this read page, read file object here. And then the page that we want to read from the PDF is stored in the page variable. So till now, what we have done is, firstly, we have created a book to which stores the path and which defines what function we need to perform on the PDF. Secondly, we have created an object to read the PDF file. And then in the third step, we have located the page which from which we want to read from. And then the fourth step is to extract the page. Now that we have found the page that we want to read from, now the next step will be extracting the text from that page. And extract text is a function used for that. We use the page variable and extract text function, and the extracted text will be stored as a text stream in the text variable. So now that we have the text stream in the text variable, we just need to output that text. For that, there is a function called say of the PyPDF text to speech file conversion library. So in this function, we need to pass the text stream called text, and the speaker which we have initialized here, we have to use speaker.say. This is the code which will convert the text to text from the PDF to speech, and then we have to write speaker.runandwait. So run and wait is important here, because what it does is it will make sure that the execution of the program gets completed and it is not interrupted. So speaker.runandwait is used for that. So this was the main algorithm of the program, wherein firstly you locate the path, then you create the object, then you locate the page from which we want to read, and then you extract the text, and then you output the text using a speaker. So the next button was close. So for closing the program, it is pretty easy. As you can see, I have given the command as bye. So the by function here just contains one line of code called app.destroy. So if you want to close the GUI which you have made, you just need to write app.destroy and the GUI will be closed. And the last part here is, if you'd observe that whenever you start the program, first thing that you hear is welcome to your audiobook. So for that, this is the code I have written. Firstly, again, I have initialized the speaker variable, and before using the speaker or any variable of your choice in the text-to-speech conversion library, you need to initialize it. And then you can also set various properties to the speech. Like here I have set the rate to 140. Like you can change the volume, you can set the rate, you can also change the gender of the voice, etc. So I have set the property of rate to 140, and then you can give the text whatever you want to output. And then again, as I explained, speaker.run and wait is used. So that was all about this program, and I hope you understood it well. Thank you.